Hi, Michaela Harris here. I wanted to take just a few minutes today to show you what you could be doing to outrank your competitors online and grow your business by utilizing this beautiful website. Now, I did come across your company as someone who was paying for Google Ads, so I wanted to take a look at your website, and when I did, I noticed that it's not really serving you at all. So, most people think that having a website is a great thing. However, websites are meant to be found in search engines. So without search engine optimization, which I'm about to show you what that is, these websites are not serving you anything. If you're not on that first page of Google, you're not getting anything out of this website. So what I want to show you is how to utilize this. Now, just one thing to note, having a beautiful website that does not rank is about like having a beautiful car with no gas. You need this website to work for you. And how you do that is by understanding Google algorithms. Now, if I take a look, there's not 1,500 words of content. Now, 1,500 words of content is important because that's what Google algorithms look for when it crawls a web page. Your homepage needs to have 1,500 words with good keywords throughout that content, and any images on your website need to save as keywords as well. And also, you want to make sure that the way your website is structured is in a way that's going to aid it in ranking for different services, different products, or different locations. Now, that means having your service areas, instead of just having one page, you want to have one page for each area that you serve. Now, I did notice that you serve several cities in Georgia, so I would have one for each one of those cities. And each one of these back pages needs to have 500 to 750 words of content with keywords on them as well. And then any of your service pages need to be molded around what volume is out there and for which services. You want to have a separate page for each service that has a high search volume. Now, your Google Business Profile is good if all of your service areas are in a relatively close-knit place. Having one Google Business Profile is fine, but if you're branching out to other areas that are a decent distance away or have a lot of search volume for themselves, you're going to want to have one of these for each place. Now, four things you're going to want to make sure you're doing with this: getting plenty of geotagged optimized images, plenty of Google reviews. You want to make sure you're utilizing that 750 word description. Looks like you're doing pretty good there. And then you want to make sure you're going after plenty of citations, which are just business listing sites like Yelp or Yellow Pages that list your name, address, and phone number. Now, the reason why that's important is you want to make sure that however many photos, reviews, or citations that you have is more than what your competitor has. It's going to help bring you to the top of this map section. Now, why this is important is if I'm searching this keyword, Lawn Care Atlanta, Georgia. Now, I picked that one just because you're Weed Pro Lawn Care. I did notice landscaping's on there. Landscaping tends to have a little bit higher of a search volume, but I just wanted to show you lawn care as an example. Now, as a potential customer, when I search this keyword, which is a buyer intent keyword, it means there's a service and a city. When someone searches this right here, they're looking with the intent to make a purchase of a product or service. That's what's important. That's what's going to turn into revenue for you if you can convert these customers. But the only way to do that is to be in this top three or on this first page. Now, 9 out of 10 people will never click that second page of Google. Most won't even click more businesses. So you want to be as easy as possible for your customer to find, and you'll get the most amount of traffic by being in the top three here and in that first position here. First page is important. First position is the best. Now, if I take a look at what your website's currently doing for you, it looks like it's doing quite a bit, and it looks like you're getting quite a bit of traffic. However, what's important to note here, also I want to make a note, your UR and your DR is not the greatest. Your UR is okay, your DR is pretty low. That just tells me you probably got some really low quality spammy backlinks that's driving your score down. But what I noticed was that most of the things that you are ranking in the number one position for are things that relate to your education page or your blog posts, and that's why you're getting all this search volume. However, what's super important here are those buyer intent keywords. Now, I'm going to show you your top competitor, which is Atlanta Lawn Care Services, and this is what their keywords look like. Now, landscapers in Atlanta, 1,500 searches every single month. Lawn Care Atlanta, $350. Atlanta Lawn Care, $300. $250. If you take a look, that is a ton of people. That's over 2,000 people that's searching for lawn care in Atlanta. Now, if I take a look at your website again and show you what you're looking at here, if we filter by Atlanta and filter by volume, I'll show you that right here at Lawn Care, 300 searches, you're ranked 56. No one's finding your website for that. So the things that you're ranked number one for are not things that are bringing you in buyer intent customers. So people who are actually looking to hire you. If it's bringing you in people that's for things like Kudzu or whatever, like things that go to your blog pages or your education pages. Now, you could say Atlanta Weed, 350, but you're still not ranking for that either. We go down here to some of these higher ones. Let's see. Lawn Care Atlanta, 200, you're ranked 67. If you can tell here, for all of these, though, that have the Atlanta name in them or are also buyer intent words, you're not ranking for any of them, which means you're not utilizing all of that traffic that is available to you. Over 2,000 people searching, and none of them can find you. So it's important to have a website that's going to function to serve you, and you're going to do that by getting it optimized and making sure it ranks on that first page of Google, getting good backlinks to go behind it, getting rid of those spammy backlinks, and optimizing that Google business profile. So ultimately, I hope this information was helpful, and please don't hesitate to reach out if you have any questions. Thank you for taking the time to watch, and I hope you have a great rest of your day.